Hi, this is Cher from Cher's Crafting Boutique. I was at my local car boot sale the other day and I came across this fairy jewellery holder. And as you can see, it's seen better days. And so therefore I've got to take it apart and do it back up again, which I thought would be a nice little thing to do. So I've got a few bits together and I'm going to show you. I'm going to start. So I have got out some of my favourite ribbon lace, as I use near enough in every video, which this was from the range for £1 for 2 meters. Get it in cream and white. I have this, which was in the pound shop at Christmas time. And they're like little diamante drops on a chain. So I've got a bit of this here. I've got different, this is a crochet in white. So I have that one. I have this here, which is a scarf. It's got this edging here. I've got this from eBay. It comes from Hong Kong, so it does take a while to come through. I think I paid about £1 for it. I've used this before in other videos. I have these diamantes in different sizes and designs, along with one that has butterflies on with the pink diamantes. These were all from the pound shop, along with this with the tiny pearls. I have a range of flowers, some paper roses that I use all the time. Again, these were from AliExpress, and so was this one. I've used these before in my videos as well, along with these. Don't know if I'm going to use all these, but I've got them out just in case. I also have this applique that I made in another video, so if you haven't seen that, please go check that out. And I have this twine that I got from The Works. Yes, I think it was £1 or £2, and you get 100 meters on it, so bargain really. Also have these, which were from the pound shop as well. There was a set of 4 of them. I have my needle and thread, hot glue, and some scissors. Let's take a look where we're going to start. First of all, I want to take off these, which you can see are in a right mess. I've seen better days, so I'm going to cut them off. Have wire in them, so I'm just going to use my clippers. Just lay it down there. Try and get the best of this off as I can. So it looks like it goes into the hair. Secured inside there. Oh look, it came out even better. So move them out of the way. Chuck those ones in the bin, I think. Right, so now we have that. What I'm going to do now is take my twine. Now what I want to do with this, run it through on this pole all the way to the bottom. So I'm going to start it off and then I'm going to pause, so then you don't have to watch all that part, because it'll go on for a bit. I'm just going to pop a little bit of glue there and secure that down. this end through. So all I'm going to do here, so I'm going to run this down a little bit, because what I want to do, I might not do this off camera yet, I don't know, because I'm just thinking. I know I started this off, I remember there was something else I wanted to do. I'm going to leave that there and grab my paper roses. Now what I want to do is put one of my paper roses in. Now I don't know if this is going to work on this bar up. I don't think it will, so I'm going to bring it down so you can see it at the sides here, and then I'm just going to wrap it around the back underneath. Be a bit fiddly, but we'll get there. And then I'm going to cover that with the twine so you can't see all this, and then I think I'll take it over first and then cut that excess off like so, and I'm going to do that a few times. Move that out of the way, get some more paper roses out here, and I'm going to do it on the opposite side, just run it around the back. Whirl it round. And secure it down there. You can hear all the kids in the back there, that's because I've got my window open. It is really warm today. So I'm just going to continue to keep going down with this. It just goes to show, when you buy something, you can do it back up. Bring it back to life. Which is always a nice thing. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause the video and be back. As I finish doing these roses back and forth, so I'll be back in a moment. Right, so far that's what I did. I put the roses on and I went round with the twine. I thought I'd do that part off camera so you didn't see me have to keep twirling it round. And just to make it easier for myself, I used a needle with the thicker opening at the top for the thread to go through, or the twine to go through, and I just reeled that all the way around. And now I am going to take some more of these roses and just take off those stems. Just going to take a couple at a time because I don't know if I'm going to use them all. And then just stick them around the bottom here at random. Leave it there because I have plans for the bottom there and I don't want them to cover the growers. So that's what we have so far. And I think it's coming together nicely. So now I am going to just grab some of this crochet, some of the Diamante drops, and my favourite, move all of this out of the way. And I'm going to start with putting this, gluing it just to the edge here, all the way around. So that's where we're starting. I'm going to start at the back, so I'll turn it around. Put a little bit of glue on here. And just secure that onto the edge there. Now at random I'm just going to put a very thin line to secure this down.
You put that on your thumb so you don't burn yourself. On your thumb.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now put it on your thumb, that finger.
It's alright, I'm only putting a thin amount, so it's not really going between them.
Well, you'll need it for the layers anyway, won't you?
Yeah. And take this all the way round. Like I said, it is just a thin amount of glue, just to secure it enough, but we don't want it to show too much. Hope you can see what I'm doing properly, because I have it facing me.
Yeah, I can. Zoom it in a bit more.
Oh, good. Onto this last little bit here. Secure that down and cut the excess like so. And that's what we have so far, and I think that looks really good. Love the way that looks. Now I am thinking about running this around that edge there. But I have plans to put something on there first, so I'm going to pop that to one side and see how that goes. Right, let's take a little look. I don't know. Now you know me on this lace, it's any excuse to use it, but I don't know if I'm going to need it today. Should make a change. So what I'm going to do here, it's got my thread already with the needle. I'm just going to cut that there, it's fine. Right. Now, make sure it's the right way up. And I think I'm going to cut a little bit of that off where it's all frayed. Best scissors to do for this, but it will do. Mind everything out of the way so don't get caught up. And all I'm gonna do is run it back on itself a couple of times to tie it, make sure it doesn't come undone when I do the gathering stitch. So that's all I'm going to do is a gathering stitch along that edge there. Take that off for a minute. I'm And the good thing about this is you don't need a lot of it, so you're using again up the scraps you've got lying around. I'm just going to keep going along until I think I've got enough. Just want a nice gathering. Just go up there, bring that back round. There's my son shouting at the game. They take it so seriously. As soon as they can't win something, I don't get it. I'm just going to continue to keep doing this until I think I've got enough, and I think I'm nearly there, so. Like a herd of elephants, y'all.
Yeah. Nah, I'm more like horse trapping myself.
Do you want to tell him to keep the noise down? He's being put on YouTube. That's You're not hard. Like that.
Get the drums and guitar and that now.
Yeah, I'm shouting at his game as he does.
That's alright.
A couple more should do that.
Eh?
And then just cut that excess off. Now I'm not going to secure this yet, because what I want to do with it is pop it around the bottom there, like so. And now I'm just going to secure the two together. When I don't catch the thread around the bottom, that is. There we are. Just secure that round, and all I'm doing is just pulling the two together. So I've taken it through the opposite side and pulling it together. And I'm just going to go back and forth doing that again. Do you want to zoom this camera in a little bit so they can see what I'm doing? So I'm just attaching both sides together there. And that's it. This bit up in the middle so I don't get caught on the edge there again. And there we go. Happy with that. I'm going to cut that excess off there. And that's what we have so far, coming together nicely. Now to make sure this is not as loose, just underneath, I'm going to lift this up. And just right at the top here, I'm going to put a little bit of glue. I'm going to do that all the way around so it's secured, but it still lifts up to give that nice effect. Now, where I put it together here, I'm going to fold them in on each other and then glue it down so you don't see all that frayed edge. So just a nice thin amount of glue there going across. Secure it down together, just pinch them together. There you are. That's that bit done. Now, I'm going to put another knot in this because the other bit I was thinking about doing is putting a nice layered skirt underneath. Now, I don't know. I'll have a look, see if I still want to do that. Yeah, I think I will. So, this is where the scarf came into it. So, what I'm going to do here, as you can see, I don't know if you can tell in this light, but it's very sparkly, which I think is just a lovely design with all these little flowers on.
Can I just pause there? I've got to answer this for me.
Okay, and we're back.
Sorry about that.
That's okay. Right, I'm just going to cut off. I've got this access that I've cut the trim off before. And I'm just going to cut that off there. This doesn't have to be done perfectly at all. And as I have said before, if you don't have the same as me, don't worry about it. You use whatever you have, it will do just as good. So this is what I have. Now, because of all this raggedy edge on the end, I'm going to cut a bit of that off.
No one pop a fabric scissors.
Not for this, it's just very thin. You don't really need it.
It's just to get a straight line or that.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be perfect. I'm not looking for perfection.
Well, that was when I married you.
That's nice. So I am going to fold that over like that. But what I'm also going to do is take some of this trim off. I'm unsure how much I'm going to need, so I'm just going to take a bit, see where we go. It's me measuring. Don't like it, as you know. I mean, I'll do it if I have to, but I try to avoid it. I'm going to take it that little bit more and then leave it there. I think that should do it there. Move that out of the way. Now, what I am going to do here is another gathered stitch, once I don't take it out of the needle, that is. And as I've folded it over, just a second. Right, as I've folded it over there, that's because I want it to gather together and make it flare out more. So again, we are just going to make sure it goes through the two layers. Do a couple of stitches back and forth on itself to make sure that it doesn't come undone, just like we did before. And then just gather it up. Again, making sure I've got both layers at the same time. all the way along. So it gives it more of a gathered, even if it is a bit too much here, I don't mind. So there we are, hold that all together, and I think that looks really nice. And I'm going to pop this around the bottom here. And then again, this is a bit awkward to say, so I'm going to pop that down. I have this hole here, as you can see. I hope you can, but it's what's connected to it. So I'm going to push that, the needle underneath. I'm working around all of this here. And then I'm going to attach it to the other side. It's going to take a little bit of fiddling here because I can't take it apart to do it. So I'm just going to run it back and forth underneath the pole there to the other side to attach it together. And I'm going to cut that excess off. And then I'm going to push it up and put some hot glue in there to make sure that stays secured. Just run a thin amount of hot glue in here. So I know it ain't gonna come off. And there we are. And then again, where the fastening is on both sides, I'm gonna run a little bit thin amount of glue there to attach them both together. And now I'm going to do the same again, another gathering for this other piece, just not the end here. I hope I have been so far.
Yeah, I've been zooming in and out, but right there, you're just not in frame.
there's just a quick one in stitch. I'm going to pause it there so it saves you having to watch me do another running stitch that you've already seen me do twice. So, back in a moment. So, I've sewn it and stuck it back on the same way as I did the bottom layer. Now, what I'm going to do, because I want this to come up and stick to the bottom here, I'm going to put a tiny little dab of glue underneath each one of these and stick it down. Stick that there. I want it to look like it's attached to the rest of the dress. Doing that all the way around. It looks something like this. Pull that one down on that side slightly because I want to make sure it goes right under. It's not sitting right. Right, let's take a look. I have these big pink roses, which I'm going to pop one to the front here. It's already got a stickiness on the back, but I'm going to stick a little bit of hot glue on there anyway. Get my finger thing there in case I end up burning myself, which I probably would if I didn't. Just want to stick that to the fabric, not to the underneath. So, and then bring a couple of other pieces onto the table here. So, in this packet, and then I'll come and give you. Now, I have these, and I am thinking about just popping that onto here, like so. There we are. These are really sticky, so I don't think I'm going to need to put any more glue on there, so that's what I've decided to do with it. Pop them to one side. Now, I've got these tiny gems and more larger ones. Let's take a look. Now on the ends, I want to stick the little pink ones. So I need that over slightly. I'm going to put a tiny dab hot glue onto the ends here. And then put a little deep pink gem on. So literally just a tiny dab of glue for this. I don't want it overflowing over the edges there. Just enough to make sure I don't just come flying off. I do have an adhesive back, but it's not very strong, so I don't really want to leave it with that. One here. I made them out of the way. No longer need the pink. Don't think I'll be needing them after all either. I'm going to take a little look at these ones now. I'm going to put a couple of little dots on each petal. These come up individually, they're not like the other ones where they're on a little sticky chain and you've got to break them. See what I've done there, so I'm just going to pause the video, put two on each petal, and then I'll be back. Okay, so this is what we have so far. I'm liking the way it looks. So now I am going to take this chain that I was showing you before that I was going to put around her waist. I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to stick it from the back here and just put a small amount of glue. And then bring it round. Next, I'll put another small amount. And you really just need a small amount for this. And then just cut off the excess here. So that's what we have. Now I'm going to take this and pop this onto the back here. So it looks as though she's got wings. A little bit more glue onto the back here. I'm just going to run it like a line down the middle there. And then quickly secure it to the back. And then run a little bit underneath the flower here and secure that down as well. And that's how it's looking, which I love the way that looks. And then I've got this flat one. And what I'm going to do here, just cut that off. As you can see, she's got a hole in her arm here where she's lifted it up. And I'm going to pop that in there like that. So I'm just going to put a little bit of hot glue around the arm here. Pop the stem through and secure that down. And then with the stem there at the back, I'm just going to put a little bit of hot glue underneath to secure that wing and the stem down. And I think that it doesn't need anything more than that. Let's have a look though. I do have some pearls. Don't know if I'm going to add them. Where are they? There they are. Yeah, I think I'll give her a little pearl bracelet on this arm here. I think I'm only going to need about three. So I'm just going to cut three off there so it's on a chain. Thin amount of glue along there and then pop the pearls on. There we are, and I think that's it. So the next time you're at a car boot and you see something and you think it's really nice but it's really had its day, think again. Because you can bring it home and do it up with the little bits that you have lying around. All those things you've been meaning to use but never got round to it. And it could turn out looking like this. So thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. I now have a Facebook page. It's just started out. It's called Cher's Crafting Boutique. If you would like to come and join us, we just post some pictures of the things that we make to inspire other people. If that's the kind of thing you like doing, please come along and join in. Thanks. Bye.